Anthony Viney.
When the piranhas left school, they were called up, but were found by an army board to be too mentally unstable, even for national service. Denied the opportunity to use their talents in the service of their country, they began to operate what they called the operation. They would select a victim and then threaten to beat him up if he paid them the so-called protection money. 4 months later, they started another operation, which they called the other operation. In this racket, they selected another victim and threatened not to beat him up if he didn't pay them. 1 month later, they hit upon the other operation. In this, the victim was threatened that if he didn't pay them, they would beat him up. This, for the Piranha Brothers, was the turning point.
Doug and Dinsdale Piranha now formed a gang, which they called The Gang, and used terror to take over nightclubs, billiard halls, gaming casinos, and racetracks. When they tried to take over the MCC, they were, for the only time in their lives, slit up a treat. As their empire spread, however, we in Q Division were keeping tabs on their every movement by reading the colour supplements.
A small-time operator who fell foul of Dinsdale Piranha was Vince Snetterton Lewis.
One day I was sitting at home, threatening the kids, and I looked out of the hole in the wall, and I saw this tank drive up, and one of Dinsdale's boys gets out, and he comes up all nice and friendly-like, and says Dinsdale wants to have a talk with me. So he chains me to the back of the tank and takes me for a scrape round to Dinsdale's. And Dinsdale's there in the conversation pit with Doug and Charles Paisley, the baby crusher, and a couple of film producers, and a man they called Kierkegaard, who just sat there biting the heads off whippets. And Dinsdale said, "Oh, you've been a naughty boy, Clement." And he splits me nostrils open and saws me leg off and pulls me liver out. And I said, "My name's not Clement." And then he loses his temper and nails my head to the floor.
He nailed your head to the floor?
At first, yeah.
Another man who had his head nailed to the floor was Stig O'Tracy.
Stig, I've been told that Dinsdale Piranha nailed your head to the floor.
No! No, never! Never! He was a smashing bloke. He used to give his mother flowers and that. He was like a brother to me.
But the police have film of Dinsdale actually nailing your head to the floor.
Oh, yeah, well, he did that, yeah.
Why?
Well, he had to, didn't he? I mean, be fair, there was nothing else he could do. I mean, I had transgressed the unwritten law.
What had you done?
Well, he never told me that. But he gave me his word that it was the case, and that's good enough for me with old Dinsy. I mean, he didn't want to nail my head to the floor. I had to insist. He wanted to let me off. There's nothing Dinsdale wouldn't do for you.
And you don't bear him any grudge?
A grudge? Old Dinsy, he was a real darling.
I understand he also nailed your wife's head to a coffee table. Isn't that right, Mrs. O'Tracy?
Oh, damn! Yeah, well, he did do that, yeah. He was a cruel man, but fair.
Vince, after he nailed your head to the floor, did you ever see him again?
Yeah. After that, I used to go around to his flat every Sunday lunchtime to apologise, and we'd shake hands, and then he'd nail my head to the floor.
Every Sunday?
Yeah. But he was very reasonable about it. I mean, one Sunday...